Gracewood is a typical village primary school. Sited off the village green, it has only 54 pupils and 2 classrooms, but parents and teachers believe it offers the best education possible. There are now fears, though, that schools like this one, which have been a part of the community for centuries, could close. Indeed, tiny schools across the southeast are being targeted for closure because of falling school rolls and fears they won't be able to meet the needs of the national curriculum. For Gracewood, the situation is that either they fall into line with Surrey County Council's plans to take pupils up to the age of 11 instead of the 5 to 9-year-olds they take now, or close. Parents are determined, though, that come what may, they won't let that happen.
We're not going to see the school close, absolutely not going to see it close. It's too good. It's exactly the sort of school that parents would like their children to start education in. I've got a daughter here, I've got 2 sons who I expect and intend to go to this school. We've got 60 to 70 pupils there, 3 or 4 teachers, a warm family atmosphere. So we're going to fight and fight and fight to keep the school open. We want to keep it open within the present system.
In Kent, it's a similar story. Education authorities are under pressure to rationalise the education system and close schools which aren't viable. Here at Falcombe Primary, which has just 36 pupils, it was a matter of the parents joining together to save the school from closure. They organised a covenant scheme which gives the school £4,000 a year.
We cover the curriculum with the science and the humanities. It's small, it's friendly. There's a good relationship built up between the children and between the children and staff and consequently the parents. And it's this intimacy is why the school is so popular and people are willing to travel to it.
Tomorrow, a report's out by the Audit Commission, which shows that there are 1 in 5 primary desks lying empty. And it's claimed hundreds of millions of pounds are going to waste. If the report's facts are accepted, the reality could be hundreds of small local schools closing their doors for good. This is Githa Hutton for Thames News.